Hey y'all, Matt here from Super Niche Sites. In the video today, I'm going to be talking about RankIQ. And specifically, I'm going to be talking about how I use RankIQ to optimize my existing blog articles. Now, the example today is actually an article that I got from one of my subscribers. They sent it over to me and they were like, hey, could you help me out with this article? What I'm doing wrong? Those sorts of things. So I figured it would make a perfect example to run through RankIQ. So that's what I'm going to go ahead and do. I'm going to go ahead and run it through and we will see what's wrong with it according to RankIQ software, what we can do to upgrade it. So that's kind of what I'm going to be showing you in today's video. If you've never heard of RankIQ or you're interested in learning more about it, you can find a link to it in the description below. Also, if you would, please subscribe to our channel. Now let's go ahead and hop into that article and how you can optimize articles using RankIQ. So here we are on the RankIQ dashboard, and this is after you log in and sign up. I'm currently on the $49 a month plan, and that gets you 16 reports. As you can see right here, I have 8 reports left for this month. I'm gonna be using one of them for this video. That'll kick it down to 7. You get 16 of these content optimizer reports per month. You can also use RankIQ to get keywords. That'd be the keyword library. You can use it to check rankings. You can create or add a whole bunch of keywords to your personal keyword library that you want to write on sometime in the future. So there's different things you can do for it. Today specifically, I'm going to talk about how I use RankIQ to optimize content using their content optimizer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a new report. Typically, when you're looking to run a new report, let me copy this. That's the keyword we're going to be running the report on. You're going to go to the keyword library and maybe you're going to click on a phrase, or so you can select by niche or you can just select down here by keyword. So for example, let's say I have a website that is about alcohol. So I could type in alcohol and then I can apply filters, and RankIQ is going to give me all of these different keywords that have the word alcohol in them that they designate as low competition that newer blogs can rank for. Now they have competition, how many visits per year. When I'm searching for a keyword, I'll typically will do sort by the visits per year, high to low, and then what I'm looking for is something like this, okay? Lower competition, higher visits. Right here, lower competition, higher visits. So it's how long after wisdom teeth removal can I drink alcohol? When can I drink alcohol after tooth extraction? Okay, it's pretty similar. So if you have a website about alcohol or if you have a website about dental or teeth, then both of those would probably be very good. So what you can do is you can just click run report from here for any keywords. And that's how I will traditionally use it when I'm creating a new blog article. However, when I'm going through and optimizing a blog article, like what I'm going to be showing in this video, I'm just going to use the reports here on the first page. So I'm just going to paste that in. The article that we're going to be optimizing for the subscriber today is does Olive Garden serve alcohol? So I'm going to be covering that. So then you're just going to click run new report. Now this does take probably 60 to 120 seconds. So a minute or two approximately. Sometimes it'll take 30 seconds. Sometimes it'll take full 2 to 3 minutes, but it doesn't take too terribly long. However, I'm not just going to sit here and babble on while that's doing. I'll go ahead and hop out of this and then we'll come right back in as soon as this report is done running. So that took about a minute to run this report. Does Olive Garden serve alcohol? And then what will happen is it will show up this report and it'll show you the content grade that they suggest that you hit, which is A++. Also, they suggest a word count and then the sources that are analyzed. Now, what you can do is you can scroll down and look at all of these different topics that Google wants you to cover. This is based on the top articles that are currently ranking for this. And so you can scroll through and add these and those sorts of things. If you're creating an article, that's good. What I'll do when I'm creating an article is I'll go through and create subheadings based on these. So alcoholic beverages, Italian margarita, Italian restaurant, white wine. So these are going to be lists of what alcohols does Olive Garden serve. That's going to be a subheading. And if this article that I'm optimizing here doesn't have that, then we will add that in. However, since I'm optimizing an article, I'm not going to go through all of this just yet. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click here. I'm going to go to the content optimizer. Then I'm going to copy this article that I'm going to be optimizing for the video today and click it in. Now, as you'll notice right here at the top, it says grade F and word 0. Sometimes RankIQ does that. All you have to do is simply click into it and click enter, and then that'll show up the correct grade and also the words. So this one that's starting off is a D, and this is pretty common for articles that are written by people who don't use long tail keywords, don't use any type of services or anything to figure out which keywords they need to add in. This is just them writing the article to the best of their ability, and they got a D. It's not like it's bad. It just means that they need a lot of these keywords. So it does have some of these on the right-hand side. What I'll typically do is I'll click on Show Unused. And these are ranked from top to the bottom by the importance of these keywords. Okay. Now what you'll see in here is Olive Garden restaurant, Italian restaurant, best things, non-alcoholic drinks, orange juice, Olive Garden location, senior discount, 10-year-old boy, wait staff. Okay, some of them are going to apply and some of them aren't. Like, I'm not going to add in a phrase or even a paragraph about something about a 10-year-old boy when I'm talking about Olive Garden and alcohol. It just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But it was just mentioned in one of the top articles that's currently ranking on Google for this. So that's why that's in there. Okay, parent company, probably not going to do that. Delivery orders, I might do that. Outback Steakhouse, maybe. Darden Restaurants is good. That's the owner of Olive Garden. So I could say something like all Darden restaurants do X or all Darden restaurants do Y. Okay, soft drinks, pineapple juice, copycat recipe, last year, Longhorn Steakhouse. That's again a Darden restaurant. I believe Outback is as well. Cheddar Scratch Kitchen. Okay, so those are some different restaurants. Head-to-head Rosé, Olive Garden Secret Menu, Indianapolis Olive Garden, 10-year-old child again, child orders. Okay, so there's maybe a news article or something about a child ordering alcohol at Olive Garden, a 10-year-old child, not sure. But I'm not going to write any of those things. So you do want to use your brain for these. But what you're going to do, I'm going to do, is I'm going to go through and edit it. Now, what I'll typically do is I will not edit it in the RankIQ Content Optimizer. You can. What I prefer to do is just edit it in here in Google Docs. And that's simply because Google Docs is going to check for spelling errors, it's going to check for grammatical errors while I'm going through and while I'm working on this. So let's go ahead to the top one. I've got Olive Garden Restaurant. That's what I want to use. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply Control F and I'm going to type in Olive. Okay, so I've got all of these different references to Olive throughout my article. Obviously, it's written about Olive Garden, so it's going to have a lot of Olive in it. And what I'm looking for is I'm looking for one or two of those instances where I can change it from just saying Olive Garden to saying Olive Garden Restaurant. So let's see where that makes sense. If you're more of a foodie and prefer to celebrate by eating comfort food, Olive Garden is one of the best restaurants that not only offers comfort food, but alcohol as well. Let's leave that alone. And we'll skip down through here. Here we go. Here's perfect. Here's a perfect example. Some Olive Gardens. Okay, so some Olive Garden restaurants. And that doesn't need to be an apostrophe. Okay, some Olive Garden restaurants offer wines specific to the location as well. Okay, let's scroll down here. And let's see what else we have. If you're dining at, okay, here's another example. An Olive Garden restaurant. Okay, so I just added two of them into there. Now, what I'll typically do is I will go through and work on adding maybe three or four of these before I paste it back into RankIQ. Again, you can do it right in here. However, if you have images, if you have formatting, RankIQ will typically mess it up. It won't hold on to the formatting properly. Like as you can see, it just makes these giant blocks of text, takes out all the spaces and those sorts of things. So that's why I like to edit it either in Google Docs or in WordPress itself. Okay, so we got Olive Garden. So now we're looking for Italian restaurant. Okay, so that could probably be something we add at the top. If you're more of a foodie, when you go out to dinner, it should always feel like a celebration. You can go celebrate birthday, promotion, work, leaving to talk about it. I'm just celebrating that you made another day. Whatever reason, if you're celebrating with going out to eat, you prefer to celebrate with alcohol, it's important to know whether or not the restaurant you were going to serves it. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a little paragraph in here. Olive Garden is a popular Italian restaurant that serves great food at great prices. Okay, so we're gonna do that. Okay, obviously need to capitalize that. And we're gonna edit this a bit and we're gonna take out that section. They serve mainly pastas and other types of comfort food that everyone seems to enjoy, period. Okay, let's see here, I misspelled, no big deal. Okay, and then I'm going to erase that, and I'm going to leave that section. Olive Garden is one of the best restaurants that not only offers comfort food, but alcohol as well. Okay, Olive Garden has an extensive alcohol menu. There's something on the drink menu for everyone. There are red wines for those who prefer a dry taste, and white for those who like their drinks sweet. Okay, and then below it gives the current full alcohol menu. Their wines, red wines, white wines, specialty drinks, beer, Bud Light, all those different things that it serves. Okay, so I've added a couple things in. I'm going to copy that over. I'm going to go over here to RankIQ, delete that, and I'm going to re-put it in. All right, now you can see adding those two things put me up to a D plus. Okay, so we're going up a little bit. It takes a little bit of time. Okay, so we've got best things. Okay, so here's the current full alcohol menu. Okay, not every location will offer the same alcoholic beverage options. Some Olive Garden restaurants offers wine specific to their location as well. Let's go down here. One of the best things. Okay, see what I did there? I pulled best things from here at the top. One of the best things to order with your pasta dish is a nice wine. That is why Olive Garden, I can't spell, Garden gives so many different wine options for you to choose from. They will often give out free samples of their wine to anyone that asks if you aren't sure which wine of theirs you prefer. Okay, so I know this, if this is going to be way too boring of a video, I do apologize. I'm going to show you 100% me going through and how I optimize this, and this is exactly how I do it. So I'll go through and I will add in some keywords where I can. And then I'll go through and add maybe a paragraph or two. Now we were on this article, the person who wrote it was, I think we were a little over 1,000 when we first started. So I've got it up to 1,100. I just added another paragraph, so it's probably gonna be like 1,150. RankIQ recommends that we get up to 1,292, so about 1,300 words. So by going through and adding these paragraphs in that use these words, I am going to be able to not only get my grade up, but also get my word count up to the recommended amount as well. Okay, so that was best things. Non-alcoholic drinks, I think I actually want to add. Okay, so we've got a section about non-alcoholic beverages. I was gonna add a section about non-alcoholic drinks, but there are some reasons why an alcoholic drink at dinner might not be ideal for you. Whatever your drink preferences, there are still drinks all garden that everyone in the family can enjoy. All right, so let's hit enter here. There are many delicious, what was the term? Non-alcoholic drinks that you can choose from at Olive Garden, period. Some drinks that Olive Garden offers that. Okay, let's see if there's any other terms here that are non-alcoholic. So let's go down here. Okay, I'm doing the same thing. I controlled F and I'm looking for non. And I'm scrolling down this right-hand side and I'm not seeing anything that's non-alcoholic. Okay, so let's go let's try that. Okay, and I'm scrolling through here. Alcohol-related mishap. Scroll down. Nope. Okay. So, and the reason why I'm doing that is sometimes they'll have something at the top and then they'll have a different variation further down. And so if I can add both of them in a single paragraph that I'm adding in, then that works great. Okay. So because I could have added here some non-alcoholic drinks, or I could have had some drinks without alcohol. Okay. So we're going to do that. Alcohol that Olive Garden offers. Some drinks without alcohol that Olive Garden offers are, and then I'm going to give a list. Okay, now why am I doing this? One, I'm giving a list because a lot of the times RankIQ will give different drinks. So we've got orange juice, maybe that's one of the mixes, but maybe Olive Garden actually serves an actual orange juice, which is something that I'll have to go and search. So let's go here, let's look here. Does Olive Garden So serve alcohol is what we're doing. Serve orange juice. Okay, let's go ahead and look at that. Okay, so here's from olivegarden.com, non-alcoholic beverage menu. Okay, so we're gonna click into that. That makes a great addition to our article. And we can actually link directly to this portion of the menu from the article. It's gonna make me choose that. I am in Phoenix, Arizona. And let's find a restaurant nearby, maybe. Okay, while it's doing that, I'm gonna go back over here to this article. Okay, and I'm gonna do some drinks without alcohol on the Olive Garden menu. Okay, and the reason why I'm doing that is I'm going to hyperlink Olive Garden menu to Olive Garden's non-alcoholic menu. Okay, so you wanna link to these people that you're getting information from. Okay, let's keep blocking that. And Olive Garden, there we go, perfect. Okay, so I'm gonna go order now. It's just a random location here in Phoenix. And it should pull up to menu, non-alcoholic beverages. There we go, perfect. Okay, so I've got to-go gallon of iced tea, raspberry lemonade, 2 liter soda, to-go fountain drinks, raspberry lemonade, classic lemonade, mango strawberry iced tea, cappuccino, Bellini peach raspberry iced tea, fresh brewed iced tea. Okay, so those are the different non-alcoholic beverages that they have, at least based on their menu. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and go back over here. And we're gonna do soft drinks, various soft drinks. And again, I can't spell, that's why I do this in Google Docs. Okay, various soft drinks. I'm gonna go back over here, I'm gonna go back to that tab. Okay, so we got soft drinks, they call them fountain drinks, whatever. Raspberry lemonade, we'll do that next. Raspberry lemonade. All right, let's go back and see what else they have. Classic lemonade, perfect. Classic lemonade. And I'm just gonna copy and paste all of these over here. So I'll be right back with you once I get all of these different drinks that they offer right back here into the menu. All right, so I got all those in here. So now we have a list of what Olive Garden serves. And then below, we're going to leave that paragraph that they had. If you're looking for a sweet drink without alcohol, you can order one of Olive Garden's many flavors of iced tea. You have the option of original iced tea, raspberry, mango, strawberry, or Bellini peach raspberry tea, okay? As listed up above. Okay, so we're gonna do, let's leave that. Okay, sweet drink, tea. If you like your coffee, you can order cappuccino, latte espresso, prefer soda, Olive Garden carries Coke products. Okay, perfect. Okay, so I gave the list, and then I also gave it out, or they gave it out, I should say. I added the list, they gave it out in the different typing paragraphs there. Okay, so we're gonna copy that. Gonna come back here to RankIQ, and we're gonna paste, and we're up to a C. Okay, so a little bit of time. Orange juice, maybe one of their drinks has orange juice in it. Let's see what specialty drinks they offer. Peach, Bellini, strawberry, amaretto, sour, spiked strawberry lemonade. Okay, I don't see anything that would, why they would use orange juice. So we're gonna skip that one. Olive Garden location. Okay, let's see, here's the current full menu at Olive Garden. Okay, we're gonna add in a little asterisk here. Note, these might vary depending on the Olive Garden location that you are visiting. Okay, these might vary slightly. Okay, so what I did was I added in this little note, and I'm gonna italicize it, and because it might vary, okay? Also, with time, Olive Garden might change, they might stop, a certain location might be out of something, or they might stop carrying it there because it's not very popular in that area of the country. So I'm gonna add that little note, plus it also adds, it also uses one of my Olive Garden location that I am trying to use. Okay, wait staff, I know I did sample somewhere. Okay, so perfect down here. So I'm gonna do the wait staff. will often give out free samples. See what I did there? Instead of they, I just changed it to the wait staff will often give out free samples of their wine. So what I did was I used, okay, wait staff, and then went there. Okay, delivery orders. Now, these are all talking about in-store, but I'm going to assume you can't order their wine with delivery. Okay, but let's go here. Let's go to order now, and let's see how if I can even get into this. Okay, so we're gonna go order to go, and let's see if they will allow me to even order wine online from Olive Garden to pick up. They might. Never actually tried it, so we're gonna look here and see, because that would be something important for somebody to know. Okay, they know Olive Garden serves wine, but what if you're ordering it to go? You're picking it up. Can you order one of their bottles of wine with it as well? Okay, so let's scroll over here. This is all the foods, the appetizers, family style meals. Let's just add something random and then see if it'll give us drink options as well. Okay, yep, confirm and add to cart. Don't worry, that's not my location. Would you like to add extra cheese? Choose a super salad. Would you like to add a beverage? Okay, so according to this, you can't add that, you can't add that, you can't add that. You can add the soft drinks, okay? So currently, at least in Phoenix, you cannot add alcohol to, or at least at this one in Phoenix, you cannot add alcohol to your order. So let's go ahead and change this location. Let's try a different place. So instead of Phoenix, let's go ahead and try, let's see here, what's a good big city? Let's go Kansas City. Okay, Kansas City, Missouri. All right. And we'll do that one. This is Independence, Missouri. Here's Kansas City, Missouri. Perfect. Okay, order online. And what I'm doing, this is simply research. And this is what I'm going to be doing when I'm doing any article that I'm updating, whether I'm updating it for someone else or whether I'm doing it for myself. Like, I'm going to go through and I'm going to figure this out. I'm going to look and say, okay, that has delivery options as RankIQ saying I need to figure it out. So if I want to add that in, I'm not just going to make something up. I'm going to actually look it up. Okay, so let's confirm and add to cart. And let's see if I can add drinks. Yes. Okay, so I can add a bottle of wine. Okay, so at some locations you can, at some locations you can't. So that's important to know. Okay. Okay, that's perfect. And then I'm going to do this. You can also order a bottle of wine to go with your Olive Garden. Okay, what was the term? We were looking for delivery orders. We're gonna do pickup. Pickup or delivery orders, period. However, this is only available at certain locations and areas of the, let me see if there's any other words that I could throw in here that work. Delivery, pineapple juice, last year, right blend of smooth rum. Olive Garden secret menu, Indianapolis. Okay, all right, so we're gonna skip that. And we'll just finish this up. Or this is only available in certain locations and areas of the country. So when placing your we'll go ahead and end that there. Period. When placing your order, let's enter and do the next line. When placing your order, after you add your favorite dish to the cart, you can add a bottle of wine at that time if you wish. All right, as you can see here, I just added another section talking about that. That's helpful. Okay, I'm adding helpful information. That's what RankIQ is good for. It helps you find things that you missed in this article. So the person who was writing this article didn't think about, oh, I wonder about delivery. So they didn't think about that, but since I'm using RankIQ to optimize the article for them, then what they will see in here is that, oh, obviously I should have included it because a lot of the other top articles are. Okay, so we're going to copy that and we're going to go here and we're going to paste. And we're now to a C plus. Now remember, we started at D, went to a D plus, and now we're at a C plus. We still have a ways to go, but we're looking for different things that we can add. So orange juice, probably not. Senior discount. Wonder if Olive Garden gives senior discounts. Does Olive Garden give senior discounts on wine? Okay, so they don't have one dedicated senior discount policy across their stores. Okay. They don't offer age-related discounts like senior discounts. Okay, so maybe that's something we should put in. Let's see. I don't think there's anywhere where that would fit, so I think we're just going to skip it. And that's okay. It's okay to skip some of these. So Darden Restaurants, and we've got parent company. So I'm going to include that in the final thoughts here. So Darden Restaurants is the parent company of, and then I'm going to go ahead and do a little list here just to break it up a little bit. Let's enter that Olive Garden. Okay, I believe it's Longhorn Steakhouse, but we'll see which restaurants are Darden. Okay, perfect. So Darden Restaurants, if we click into it, it should give us the list. Our brands, perfect. So Olive Garden, Longhorn Steakhouse, Cheddar Scratch Kitchen, yep, and that was like 3-4 of the keywords. So we're gonna use those. We're gonna put Longhorn Steakhouse, Cheddar Scratch Kitchen, and let's go ahead and add these other ones in. Yard House, The Capital Grill, Seasons 52, Bahama Breeze, Seasons 52, Bahama Breeze, and what was the last one? Eddie V's Prime Seafood. Okay, so we'll do Eddie V's. All right. Add all of these locations. At all of these restaurant chains. There we go. Restaurant chains, you will be able to order the alcohol or non-alcoholic drinks of your choice. Many of these restaurants will have different alcoholic choices based on what pairs the best with the type of food that they are serving. Okay, and then I'm going to change this specifically, comma, Olive Garden has a wide variety of alcoholic products that you can try, whether you prefer red or white wine. Olive Garden has your palate covered. You can also order some special alcohol drinks in addition to beer. Next time you go to Olive Garden looking for different drinks to try, be sure and ask your server what wines they suggest. Okay, perfect. Copy that again. I go over here, and we're now to B. All right. So Whiteberry Frullata. No idea what that is. Pineapple juice. Not going to use that. Right blend of smooth rum. Let's see. Italian rum punch. Okay. Okay, so that's going to be something talking about that specific drink. Good idea. Head to Head Rosé, Indianapolis. Child orders slightly effervescent red wine. Wow. Okay. Rum cocktail. Okay, so I need to write probably a paragraph about the rum because I've got two things here. Of the special treat, so we'll add that below the drink thing here. Okay. We'll do this after this section about one of the best things to order with pasta. If you aren't a wine fan, Then you can order one of the mini specialty alcoholic drinks that Olive Garden offers. Okay, so we added that. I'm looking for Italian Rum Punch is a right blend of smooth rum. A popular choice is the Italian, is it Italian Rum Punch? Yeah, Italian Rum Punch. Rum Punch. And let's see, a right blend of smooth rum just sounds weird. Okay, so I might, instead of a right blend, I'm just going to do a perfect blend. Perfect blend of smooth rum. Okay, and, clicked into that. Okay, we're going to type that in there, parentheses, and that. And then we're going to scroll down here. Good idea. Okay, that'd be good. So if you're not a wine fan, then you can order one of his specialty. A good idea. Another. All right. Popular drink that is a good idea is the. Okay, what else do we have here? So rum cocktail. Smooth rum, perfect blend of smooth rum in a delicious rum cocktail. All right, see what I did there? So now I added a blend of smooth rum. Okay, so it was kind of similar, and then also the delicious rum cocktail. Another popular drink that is a good idea is, we'll do a good idea to try. To try is the, let's see what else. Is there anything here? Dining chain, raspberry juice, amaretto liquor. Okay, so we're gonna do the amaretto sour. No idea how to spell it. M-A-R-E-T-T-O, amaretto sour. And apparently I still didn't spell it right. Okay, and then, which is a nice blend of amaretto liquor and right. Yep, LIQUER. Sorry, y'all. Taking a little bit longer to do this than I thought it would. And I didn't spell that right either. There we go. Perfect print. A nice blend of amaretto liqueur. And let's see what's in the amaretto sour. What is in Olive Garden amaretto sour? Okay, I don't actually go to Olive Garden that much, so. So Italian margarita, Italian rum punch, the perfect blend of Bacardi silver rum, amaretto, and strawberry passion fruit. We're gonna go down here to, there it is, the perfect sweet and sour combination of amaretto, a sweet Italian liqueur, and sour mix. Okay, perfect. All right, so I'm gonna add this in. Sour, a nice blend of amaretto liqueur, comma. Let's see. Sweet Italian liqueur and sour mix. Yeah, we'll just go and sour mix. All right, we'll just go with that. Okay, so as you can see here, I'm adding some additional keywords. And what I'm actually gonna go through and do now, and I won't make you watch me do all of it, is I'm going to add a few more of those type paragraphs in for all of the different drinks. Okay, so I'm going to give some popular choices are this, and this is what it has in it, this and what it has in it, this and what it has in it, this and what it has in it. And what I'm doing is I'm adding more information that is currently showing on page one of Google. And so Google is already ranking pages that have that information, which means Google deems that information as needed. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'll hop right back with you once I have that added in. Okay, so I went through and added a lot of different things to it. I didn't add all of the different ones that were listed up above. Obviously, I have them listed, but I did add a few. So as you can see here, I also added this section right here, talking about a full wine list, and that's because here on RankIQ, we talk about a full wine list. I added sour mix. I added in, let's see what other ones, amaretto liqueur. I think I did that here on video with you. And then I added rum cocktail another time down here. So let's see right here. If you aren't a wine fan, you can order one of the many Italian inspired cocktails. Italian inspired cocktails was again from RankIQ that Olive Garden offers. These are Olive Garden's unique take. Again, I've got Olive Garden's unique take on right here. Yep, right here. Olive Garden's unique take. So I added that in. On popular dinner cocktails, then I left that, the Italian rum punch, a perfect blend of smooth rum and delicious rum cocktail. Another popular drink that is a good idea to try is the amaretto sour, a nice blend of that. And then always ask the menu before serving a certain wine location you are visiting. Okay, a certain wine or alcoholic drink. Since we just talked about both of those, we're going to need to change that. Okay, so I added in those few things while I was not recording, and let's see where we're at now. All right, now we're at an A minus. We're over the word count though, so that's good. Like I said, as you get, as you add in all these things, you add in paragraphs, talking about them, those sorts of things, you're going to get your word count up. So now, since my grade is an A minus, I need to get it up to an A++. Probably gonna need to add a couple more words. So Olive Garden guest is gonna be a good one. Remember, I'm gonna start at the top though. So orange juice, senior discount, 10-year-old boy, not gonna do any of those. Outback Steakhouse, no. Wildberry Frullato, I have no idea what that is. Pineapple juice, I was looking, what took me a while, and I wasn't recording, so you didn't see this, but I was going through and looking for these different words to see if they were included in any of the drinks that Olive Garden actually serves. And from what I could tell, they are not, at least not currently in the drink menu that Olive Garden has on their website. And so that's something you need to do. Like, if this word says here, don't just randomly use it. See if it actually is something that they serve at Olive Garden. If it's not, then don't just randomly add it in. You need to actually be talking about what Olive Garden actually has. That's what this article is about. Okay, so right blend of smooth rum. Obviously, we changed it to a perfect blend of smooth rum. I'm not sure how that would use that. Head to Rosé, Olive Garden secret menu. Not going to do that. Indianapolis Olive Garden, no. Child orders, no. Slightly effervescent red wine. Okay, we could probably use this. So let's go ahead and copy this. And let's go over here and let's go F and let's go to red. All right, let's go up here, Tuscan red blend head to head. Okay, so we had something head to head rosé. I don't know if that's the same or not, but let's see where else we have what red. Do you prefer a slightly effervescent red wine or a white wine? Okay, so as you can see, it bolded that, no big deal. We're just gonna unbold it all, okay? And then it changed looks like it changed the text slightly, so we're gonna make that normal, Arial, perfect. Okay, so now I added in that keyword, the slightly effervescent, red wine. Free appetizer, best meal. I'm not sure how we could do best meal. I know we could do great things. So let's just try meal and let's see if we have it. We don't even have meal in there. So let's try dinner. Okay, the best wine to drink depends on your palate. Do you prefer slightly effervescent red wine or white wine? What are you eating for dinner? That doesn't make any sense that they stopped that there. So all of these things need to be taken into account when you are choosing a wine at Olive Garden. Period. Below, I will cover some of the, let's see, what words were here? Let's see, that go best with your meal. Okay, so let's do this. Below, I'll cover some of the wine pairings that will help you have the best meal at Olive Garden that you have
ever had. All right, see what I did there? I added in best meal, and I also further explained what I was going to be talking about next. Okay, so that's good. We use that one. We use best meal. Great things. Let's see if we have great anywhere in here. Okay, so bull chardonnays are great to pair. Are great things? Maybe. Great food at great prices. Scroll down here. Not all wines taste great with fish or beef dinners. Okay, bull chardonnays are great things to pair. I don't think so. I don't like that. These, because I don't like things necessarily. Okay, great things. So we're going to skip that. We use best meal, dine in chain. Okay, so let's go to chain. At all of these, here we go. Instead of restaurant chains, we're going to change that, and we're going to do dine in chains. Now, it is important to note that if there's a hyphen in the RankIQ one, you have to add a hyphen to get it to pull up as well. Okay, so dine in at all of these, at each. Okay, so we're going to change that. At each of these, that's still chains. Interesting. Okay, we're still gonna leave it, because dine in chain is pretty good. Olive Garden guests, spokeswoman, unique take. Thought I did unique take. Okay, I did Olive Garden's unique take. I'm not sure why that didn't pull in. These are Olive Garden's unique take on popular dinner cocktails. Okay, I'm not sure. Maybe I haven't copied it over since I added that. Let's try that. Okay, still an A minus. All right, and that can be a little frustrating, but what I'll do is I'll go through and make sure that all of these, okay, Marciano Terro's chicken Alfredo. Okay, that's gonna be, so when we're talking about pasta, let's try chicken actually. Best wine for a chicken dinner. If you decide to enjoy one of Olive Garden's chicken dinners, okay, we're gonna go like their, what was it, chicken Alfredo? Yep. Chicken Alfredo. You compare it with the red wine options of the Merlot or the white wine choice, Chardonnay. Okay, so we're gonna leave that. That's that. Ginger ale, craft beer, complimentary dessert, customer service, pasta, entrees. Okay, so we're gonna go with pasta, and one of the places where we used pasta dishes, if you're doing a dish of pasta, so we're gonna change that. If you are enjoying, let's see, pasta entrees. And it's not gonna give me that little thing, is it? So we're gonna copy that. Okay, if you love Olive Garden's pasta entrees. Okay, we're gonna unbold that. We're gonna change that to Ariel just to make it uniform. Okay, perfect. So now I added pasta entrees. Never any appetizers, complimentary refills. That'd be a good section to add, but I'm already at the word count. So I'm probably not gonna worry about that. If this was my article, I would probably add a section about, maybe I will. Cause I know they're gonna talk about which ones. Okay. Which drinks offer complimentary refills? So does Olive Garden drinks have free refills? And this is just 100% what I'm doing with every article that I'm optimizing. Okay, talking about it. I'm looking for something from Olive Garden. Okay, let's see if they say, which ones have free refills. I'm gonna guess the specialty drinks don't, like the lemonades, but let's see what it says. Okay. Let's click here. And it's not gonna say, is it? It doesn't look like it. Yeah, it's not gonna say, because it's talking about ordering it. So that'd be something That'd be something that I would probably, if this was my article that I was writing for myself, I'd probably call Olive Garden and be like, hey, do you guys have free refills on your raspberry lemonade, classic lemonade, your mango strawberry iced tea, your fresh brewed iced tea, your cappuccino? And then I would add in a little section of Olive Garden offers complimentary refills. And let's just go ahead and do that. So let's do Olive Garden currently only offers complimentary refills on their on their fountain drinks, lemonades, and teas. They don't offer free refills on the cappuccino or the espresso. All right, and I am not going to publish that without double checking with Olive Garden, but for now, just to show you, I'm going to do something like that, assuming that's correct. Okay, we're going to copy that, we're going to paste, and we're now to an A. All right, so we need to add a couple more things in here. So give me a few minutes here. I'm going to scroll through and find some different things that I can add, that I can update, that I can check. And then I will get back to you as soon as that's done. Okay, so I did go through and add a decent number of these in. I added the Great Things. I added Dine-In Chain. I added, scroll down here to a few more that I added in here. I added Full Bar. I added Grilled Chicken, and I added House Wines, all right? And I haven't updated this yet, as I wanted to show you it going from an A, and let's see what happens. And now we're gonna add an A++. So by adding in those four words throughout the article, I was able to get up to the grade that it should be, and then get up to the, obviously we're over the words that it should be, we're 1562, recommends about 1300. So that is 100% how I will go through and optimize an article using RankIQ's software. Now, I know this is a long video, and if you hung around this long, I really appreciate it. But truthfully, this is the best way to go through and move your ranking from, if you're at the bottom of page one, somewhere on page two, and your article has been posted for 6 months, 8 months, something like that. This is something that you should do with the RankIQ software if you believe that the article has the opportunity to rank high, which the person who submitted this article said, I really think it'll bring in a lot of traffic once I'm ranking at the top of page one. Can you help me out? And I was like, sure, let me go ahead and do this video using RankIQ. So this is 100% a great option for you, a great opportunity. And I showed you exactly how I do that by simply using these, by adding in paragraphs, by adding in sentences, by simply changing the phrasing or the wording that I use. And I was able to get it from a D to an A++. And I was able to get the words from, I think it was around 1,000 when we started, up to 1,500 by adding in those paragraphs. So now we're green on both of those, which means this post is ready for that subscriber to put on their website to hopefully get more traffic for them. Again, my name is Matt. I'm from Super Niche Sites, and I really hope that this video has been helpful to you, showing you how to optimize articles using RankIQ.